Good morning, children. Today we will do the sexual reproduction in flowering plants. As the topic is there, sexual reproduction in flowering plants. Now, first of all, we should know that flower, it is the reproductive part of the plant. Flower is the reproductive part of the plant. Now, roots, stem, leaves, they are called as the vegetative part. In the previous video, we have done about the vegetative propagation also. And flower, as you know, it consists of four whorls or circles. Which are those whorls? Number one, they are the sepals. Sepals. Now, what are sepals? I will explain you with the help of a diagram also. Now, sepals, it is the outermost whorl. Outermost whorl of a flower, it is called the sepals, and you know they are green in color, and their main function is they protect the flower during bud condition. When the flower is not bloomed, it is in the form of a bud, and being green and also helps to perform the photosynthesis. So this is about the sepals. Number two is the petals. Petals you have seen often brightly colored showy structures. They are called the petals, and they are inner two sepals. And they are brightly colored. You know, the flowers are recognized only by their petals only. Like they are red, the rose is red. This is all because of the petals. And why they are brightly colored? Because they attract the insects for pollination. The insects are attracted due to these colorful petals. Okay, third structure is the stamen. Now, stamen, you know, it is the male reproductive part. It is the male reproductive part, and it consists of the filament and anther. If I draw a simple diagram of a stamen, this is the anther and this is the filament. So this is the diagram of a stamen. Now, what is there inside the anther? There are anther lobes, you can say. Inside the anther, the pollens develop, or you can say pollen grains. Pollens, they develop, and each pollen grain, it forms two male gametes. This is about the stamen. Next is the fourth is the carpel or pistil. It is the, as you know, it is the female reproductive part, and it consists of the lowermost part is called as the ovary. This is the long style, and you can say there is the stigma like this. So this is the ovary. If you see in the diagram, ovary, this is the style, this is the stigma. And inside the ovary, you can see the ovules, they develop. So these are the ovules, they develop inside the ovary. And this style, it is mostly, you as the shape is there, it is a long tubular structure, whereas the stigma, it is somewhat sticky. Why it is sticky? Because so that pollen grains, they can stick over the stigma after pollination. So this is about the, you can say, different parts of a flower. If children, I draw the diagram of the flower. Now, you see, first of all, how to draw the diagram of a flower? You can make the receptacle like this, and upon the receptacle you can draw the female part like this. Stigma is there. From the receptacle arise the different stamens on both sides. I'm drawing it with the free hand because biological diagrams, they are always drawn with the free hand. We never use the scale in them. So as I've told you, here is the ovary, ovules are there. This is the female part, and here, from here you can draw the petals. At the base over here, we can draw the sepals. So what are they? They are the sepals and they are the brightly colored petals. So to make them more attractive, we use these rod-like structures so that they appear a little bit showy and colorful. And this is the stamen. This is the carpel. Followed. This is the receptacle or thalamus. And this is the stalk of the flower. The stalk of the flower is known as the pedicel. So this is the structure of a flower. I have taken a simple flower so that you can know the basic parts. Though children, you have done it in the previous classes, but even then, for you to revise, I just have drawn it again. Now if you see the flowers, children, the flowers, they can be of two types. Either the flowers, they are unisexual. Flowers are unisexual. Now what do you mean by unisexual flowers? The flowers in which either male or female reproductive part is there. So they are called as the unisexual flower. For example, papaya, pumpkin, watermelon, then cucumber, etc. So they are the unisexual flowers. Now next is the bisexual flowers. What are bisexual flowers? The flowers which have got both the male and female parts, both male and female parts are present. So they are called as the bisexual flowers. For example, mustard, rose, neem, and hibiscus. Hibiscus is very common. Hibiscus is also there. So they are the unisexual and the bisexual flowers. Now after that, children, when we have done the structure of the flower, now we can do the, what is pollination? You will see what is pollination. Pollination. Now what is pollination? Pollination means transfer of pollen grains from the anther to stigma of a flower is called as the pollination. Now it is further of two types, if self-pollination and cross-pollination. Now what is there in the self-pollination? In self-pollination, the pollen grains, they are transferred from the anther to the stigma of the same plant is there. Whereas in cross, what is there in cross pollination? The pollen grains are transferred from the anther to the stigma of another plant. So that is called as the cross pollination. Now if we see which is better, you know, cross pollination is always better. Cross pollination is always better. Why? Because if their pollination, cross pollination is there, two different plants are used and it will always lead to variations which help the organisms to survive under changing environmental conditions. So this is regarding the pollination. Now the main question, very important question, which every time it comes in the board exams, it is about children, the process of fertilization in flowering plants. Now for that I will draw one simple diagram. Now see, this is the tube. Here is, I will draw one ovule. This is the ovary. Inside the ovary I will draw the ovule. Now these are the, what are these? These are the integuments. Integuments means layers. Integuments of ovule. And here you know that there is a sticky stigma. And you know this is the style, this is the stigma, I have labeled earlier also. So this is the ovule. Now inside the ovule there is the embryo sac. This is called as the embryo sac. Now children, when the development of the female, the embryo sac inside, this is the female gametophyte, inside it during development the 7 celled stages formed, that you will learn in our classes how this stage is formed. But you just remember that there is one egg cell, there is one egg cell and there is the synergids. This is the egg cell and these are the synergids. Okay, now here there are the cells on the opposite pole. These are called as the antipodal cells. Antipodal cells, and these are present at a chalazal end. Now what do we mean by chalazal end? This is the small opening through which the pollen tube enters. It is called as the micropyle. What is it called? It is the micropyle. Now what happens here? Again there is a central cell in which two polar nuclei are there. These are the two polar nuclei. Now children, first point which I want to mention is that, just listen to me what I say. I will send you the notes, don't worry. Now after pollination, I have told you, when the pollen grains, they land on stigma, you know, they have the outer covering over here. Many pollen grains, they land on the stigma like this. Now after pollination, these pollen grains, they germinate. Why they germinate? Because the stigma, it secretes a chemical substance which help the pollen grains. It provides a nutritive substance which help in the germination of the pollen tube. Now pollen tube here germinates to form the pollen grains, germinate to form the pollen tube. Now this pollen tube, many pollen tubes are formed, so many pollen grains they land on stigma, but only remember one pollen tube, it grows through the style like this. One pollen tube, it grows through the style and enters the ovule through the micropylar end like this. Micropylar end, and during its this pollen grain nucleus, it divides into two male nuclei. Two male nuclei are formed. Each pollen tube, it forms a two male nucleus, this pollen grain nucleus. Now this pollen 2, when it enters through the micropyle, here it enters the micropylar end and it releases inside 2 male gametes. This is synergids, they help the pollen tube to enter the embryo sac or the female. Now, as I have told you, this is the egg cell. Now, one male gamete, what happens? One male gamete, it fuses with the female gamete, which is that? That is the egg cell. It fuses to form the zygote. It fuses to form the zygote, and this process of fusion of male and female gamete is called as the syngamy. What do we call? Syngamy. Followed? Now, the second male gamete, as I have told you, there are two male gametes. The second male gamete, it fuses with the polar nuclei. These polar nuclei. Second male gamete fuses with these polar nuclei. Now, there are two nucleus. One male gamete nucleus is there. So, they combine to form the triploid. They combine to form the triploid endosperm. Followed, it is 3N. Polar nuclei are 2N. Male gamete is 1N. So, how the triploid nucleus is formed? Since there is formation of triploid endosperm, 3 nuclei are there. This fusion is called as the triple fusion. What is it called? Triple fusion. Here it is called as the syngamy. Now, children, here you know in plants fertilization takes place twice. One is with this egg cell and second is with this polar nuclei. So that is why fertilization in plants, it is known as the double fertilization. What do we call that? Double fertilization. So this is called as the double fertilization in plants. Now what happens? What are the post-fertilization changes? What will happen after fertilization? Now after fertilization, this zygote, it divides several times to form an embryo within the ovule. Embryo is formed. Followed? And what is this embryo? This embryo, like this. It embryo consists of the radical. Radical, and here it consists of the plumule. This embryo. This radical, it gives rise to the roots. And plumule, it gives rise to the shoot. So this is how I am explaining you again. Male gamete fuses with the female gamete to form the zygote. That is called syngamy. After that, the zygote divides many times to form the embryo. And this embryo, it has got the structures, the radical upper one, plumule lower part, radical develops the roots, plumule develops the shoot. So this is the second change. And third is, this ovule after fertilization, it develops a tough seed coat. Seed coat is developed. This ovule, it develops a tough seed coat and converts into a seed. Now it becomes a seed. And the ovary, this ovary, all this ovary, in seed is inside. This ovary grows rapidly, its size increases. Ovary grows rapidly and it turns into fruit. Turns into fruit. So these are the structures which are formed by the plants after fertilization. And what about the other structures like these sepals, petals, stamens, stigma, style? They all fall off and wither away. So this is how the fertilization takes place in the flowering plant.